Hello everybody, Matthew's playing here. Welcome back to another Last Day on Earth video. And for today's episode, on our main account here, we're going to be progressing in the settlement. Now, as you can see, I already have the resources with me that is needed to upgrade the barracks. The only thing that we're missing is 4 more light frames, but as I was doing some further improvements earlier, I was crafting a lot of things here in the settlement, so we should have everything that we already need. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna place the light frame back in there, and now let's go over to the barracks. Now, this is not really expensive, considering that I am at like tier 2 settlement, so to speak, so it shouldn't be that hard to completely finish. The garage is more harder than the barracks itself, so what we're gonna do is just we're gonna press fill up here, and we're done with the barracks. And the barracks is now level 2. I think now we can level up most of our characters here. Yeah, so we can level up. There we go, we now have Connor, and we can now level up Karma as well. I don't think we can level up Lemmy though, since that we don't have a contract of him. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna, we're just gonna use this one first. The fact that it takes so much more of these patches now to level up characters is just obscenely expensive. And you don't get these that often, which is funny. So you really have to start grinding in the settlement, or like doing the daily missions and stuff. So now we've upgraded our team. Can we do a mission? That is my question. Let's see. We can. We are powerful enough to do so. That is pretty great, actually. So let's hopefully we can do this. I've been thinking about like upgrading the truck before I do these type of things. This is going to be very loud. Lemmy's already dead because of that debuff. It's kind of unlucky. Debuffs are a thing in this game, but it is kind of apparently make things more challenging. I feel like it just makes everything unplayable. I've not been a big fan of the settlement when it came out, but it is new content and just kind of have to focus on the new content, you know. For the sake of everything. And we won. Ooh, we've got 4 hoses there. Wow, that's actually pretty great, not gonna lie. So let's continue to how far we can get before we need to upgrade once again. Oh, there are motorbikers. Let's go. These are spores, so this is probably going to be like the laboratory enemy, right? I'm just gonna play properly, see how far we can go here. Stomach ability. This is more easier than expected. Never mind. Now we really need to upgrade the truck. That is the next idea that we need to do, or task that we need to do. I'll do some further grinding soon and think about what else I need to focus on to bring you guys more content and stuff, so that you guys will see content in the later settings of the game. Oh, are we done? Nope, still more. So much more enemies. Connor is very tiny, which is good. And since we do have Karma, we can heal Connor when he does get low. So we are kind of good in that department as well. And a tip as well, don't overheat your minigun. Don't do what I'm doing. Because this is actually not good to do that. Spores. And we've done it. Pretty good. We've got a shotgun and blueprint for shotgun. Items were sent to the settlement. So that was it? Are we finished with the first region of the settlement here? I'm not sure. Seems that... Ooh. Can we not assemble a squad right now? Okay, that is very deadly. They're at 4,000 power now. Okay, so this is also pretty... The aluminum wars are the only thing that's like very expensive if you think about it, so... It's kind of a no-go. A lot of very decent items. Big ammo, I already have that. We'll just not take it, just leave it there. We will take the hoses, the rubber hose, and that should basically be everything that we need right now. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go over here and we're going to place these hoses in this workbench, and we'll create aluminum cables. So one of the main quests, or the main point of this video today, is we're going to be clearing Port Laboratory so that we can get more hoses to place in our workbench here. Now, cleaning Port Laboratory is very expensive. I'm not saying this because it's like, oh, clearing laboratory is very easy. It's not. It's very hard if you don't have prior experience to it. And I'd say that if you're just starting out and like you shouldn't do Port Laboratory until you have modifications, because Port Laboratory is just what do you call this? It's like unfair considering how much enemies there are. And yeah, I'll talk more about Port Laboratory when we're there. I'll see you guys when we're at the Port Laboratory. And we're here, we're at the Port Laboratory now. Now, I apologize for some lag that might occur when I'm recording this. I'm currently trying to find a way to fix this, but I don't know how, so I'm really sorry. So we already have everything that we need here. We have the seaweed and stuff, so we can just grab the seaweed and enter the place normally. So I brought a lot of guns and one set of armor. Hopefully this will be enough, which, knowing this game, it probably would not be enough. I've cleared laboratory many times and it still won't be probably enough, so hopefully it's enough. But if not, I'll go back home, grab more weapons, and continue clearing this place. So now we're gonna go to sector A1. Okay. So whenever you're doing Port Laboratory, make sure that at least one of your first perks is either Agility or Action Hero, because those two perks are the best perks that you can get. Agility just makes enemies not hit you, and they don't hit you for a long time. And Action Hero just makes your guns not miss. So they're both great perks. What will be the threat level? Enemies' armor is increased by 15%. That is kind of unfair. Okay, so now you exactly, that's what you do not want to get hit by. Okay, they drop a lot of what you call this? Season XP. This is great. Kinda need a lot of season XP. And you need to be careful about the those acid melters, because look at the damage. That's just one spit. It's already very low HP. It's kinda stupid that they're that OP. And I kinda hate it. Just because they're like, their whole purpose. Because the acid melter's entire purpose is to just damage your armor and break it as fast as possible so that the other zombies can kill you. Which is kind of annoying. But it's a good contrast to how hard this place is. And it's kind of horrible. Why did I take 12 damage? And as you can see, the enemies can't hit me, so the agility perk is one of the best perks that you can take, and it's not even close. Oh goodness me, this is a lot of enemies. Not good. And this is why action perk is one of the best perks that you can get. They make the AK actually. Oh my goodness. My armor has taken so much damage to the acid melters alone. Look at this, look at how much the AK misses. And if we had the, let's say, the action hero perk, you wouldn't really have this problem. And it's kind of very annoying of how, it's kind of annoying how OP that perk is, and it just makes laboratory easier than it is, you know. Just really helps with like balancing out this place. Though as a free to play, I don't know if for laboratory would be like worth it, considering the amount of things that you need to use. There we go, we got our first three rubber hoses. I don't think they would be worth it with how much you need to spend in order to clear this place. This place would probably be like a let's say like a occasional clearing. I wouldn't say that you should clear this like on a weekly basis or a monthly basis like that, because this place is just too hard and it costs too much guns to do. So I probably won't recommend you guys clearing this place very often. You probably should do it like once a month or something like that. Though, if you do have the resources to do this place and you feel the need to, you want to build up Genesis weapons to do hard mode laboratory, then yeah, you could do that, because Genesis weapons and the rewards for hard mode laboratory is kind of good. Not the best loot. I do have a video of already clearing this place, and it was one of my first videos. I'll put a link in the description below, or you can go to the eye on the top right here. I'll link it, so you guys can just click on the video if you're interested. And it basically covers, it just me clearing port laboratory, and that was just basically it. I cleared it with scars, one of the best weapons in the game. And even with scars, it took like a decent amount of time to fully clear it. Just kind of crazy to think about, actually. How did I think about it? So, if I didn't get stuck on that guy. Oh. Again, connection lost. I'm just saying, if I didn't get stuck on that guy, I'd probably... Oh, there goes my armor. Okay. My armor is just gone. This is why I hate acid melters, specifically in Port Laboratory. They are so annoying. Let's just use CBR in armor, because you know I should have removed my skin, like my skin outfit skin. But I feel like if you guys could see like my character or like my armor, that would be way better. So don't you dare spit at me. Okay, this connection loss thing is getting quite annoying now. So we're back. Just connectivity problems here and there. It's kind of got decently annoying. So now we're just gonna continue with our fill bioreactor. Oh yeah, I forgot. After you clear a floor, you need to refill the bioreactor, which is this right here. And you can see this is the amount of things that you need. And I'd say probably carrots or like seeds are gonna be your best thing to fill this place if you're a free to play. Because getting a lot of seaweed is gonna cost a lot of time. It's so stupid. So, here we have a pass perk. This perk is actually pretty good as well. If you want some extra loot, I'll look for action hero. There it is. So now our guns don't miss, which is going to be pretty great. So I can just hold down the thing here. It just doesn't miss. It's so funny. You just hold this down. Absolutely drain the enemies. So the toxic skewer is gonna spit on us. It's gonna move to this side now. Spit again. It's dead. Toxic skewer does a lot of damage. And I'm gonna get stunned. Oh goodness me. Oh, they do 24 damage. They do extra damage. What is this? They do extra damage. Toxic Spewer's healing. It's not good. Oh god. Oh, I'm good. You're both dead. Yep. And I'm taking more damage from this bit. Nice. So we're gonna get an M4 here. It's absolutely annihilated. I'm gonna get annihilated, not them. Because the Toxic Spewer is definitely unfair. Comes to enemies in this game. Does so much damage, plus it heals from his own spit. It's kinda stupid to think about. I hate it. The exploder is just basically a hard mode bunker alpha exploder. Pretty easy to deal with. Let's go like that. Let's equip kill the parasites here. I'm gonna loot the body. Loot this. I think we have enough weapons to clear floor B1. Hopefully we do. Don't want to go home and grab more guns. So just gonna finish up here. We're gonna equip another M4. We're gonna use the AK when we're at the boss fight, because we need as much DPS as we can in the boss fight. I kind of don't want him to keep hitting us. That was, oh my goodness, the lag. Okay, a lot of technical problems happening right now, so kind of not good. So just gonna hold down the weapon here. This weapon is not missing anytime soon. Action hero is just so good. Hey, they're all dead. Amazing. Who knew that one perk could literally change the entire difficulty of this place? That's the action perk. And I wouldn't say this is a pay to win. This location is pay to win because you can reshuffle perks, which is kind of like very pay to win now that I think about it. It's so funny. So it's kind of unfair, you know, because those with like a lot of coins can just reroll if they don't get like their preferred
I do make your eyes right. That is so funny. Again, that just shows like the unfairness of pay-to-win players to free-to-play ones. This is this big pay-to-win wall gap from the board, or it is so stupid. Though, I wouldn't say that's all pay-to-win. If I'm being honest, you could probably still finish this place with like probably no agility perk or no action perk, but it's just gonna take a lot more healing items, which is like annoying, because healing items aren't easy to get in this game, so it's just kind of sad that there is that like pay to win wall that you have to go through. It's not really pay to win, not really, if I'm being completely honest. It's doable, but like if you just don't get your preferred perk, you know, you just spin again. And I don't recommend you using your points on that, like your 25 points or free to play, because the game gives you 25 free points as a free to play on a new account. They give it to you as like, they give you free 25 points, and I wouldn't recommend that you use it here. So okay, Screamer, calm down, stop screaming. Gonna drain him here, grab that card, gonna make up another Uzi. Now it's just one more room before the boss of sector A sector. So we'll just open this door right now. Oh, it's not slashers. There is a chance that this room will have two slashers, which is absolutely dumb. Just gonna kill this guy. So we're not gonna have enough weapons to fully clear this place. So yeah. Go like this. Pick up so apparently the way to kill this is just go like this. I get stomp again. Now we can AK. So, and this is also the place where you get your drone, where you assemble your drone. So, this is actually, you probably would only clear this if you're going for your drone and you're going for settlement improvements, you know. So I will just clear this last Ironhead. Let's get Ironhead. So we're now just gonna clear this third floor as much as I can before I run out of guns. Then we'll go back to the settlement and let's see what we can do there. So just equip another weapon here. I think I need to eat. Here you go. It's gonna open this door again. So the non-zombie scientist. This is a suspected corpse. We're not gonna get affected because we have the CBR in armor, and the CBR in helmet specifically negates damage from the fetid corpse and the spore spreader as well. So it is kind of a very good armor, and it's pretty decent as well. It's basically a anti-radiation SWAT armor. It has, I think, it has the same defense as SWAT armor. So if you want to use CBR in armor anywhere, it would probably be here and in Bunker Bravo. I mostly use the CBR in armor in Bunker Bravo, but I don't use it here because I felt like it's useless to use it here since it doesn't really have any purpose. But like, yeah, it's just a lie that I'm getting right now. Holy fuck. Kill this exploder first. And I will go back home get the items needed, then we're going to open the boxes here. The loot boxes that we can open here. A sort of like an homage to like Bunker Alpha. So yeah, we're gonna finish as much enemies as possible. I don't even have to run the speed, I think Iron Head for reason. And Iron Head just makes you unstunnable by enemies. Oh god. Forgot Toxic Spewers goes out of that time. It's either between Toxic Spewers or Parasites. It's one of those two. And I'm like, oh goodness me. Okay, that was pretty concerning. You should not do something like that. That was stupid. And he's dead. Let's just heal again. Now it's time to use the AKs here. Okay, this is taking... There we go. The scientist. Oh god. I'm dead. Okay. I live. Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm surprised I live. Gonna kill these two enemies. Three actually. Okay. These spiky things do unreasonably a lot of damage. It's kind of stupid. There is a boss fight here, which I will not kill, because I don't need a gas cylinder anymore. And that is also a great way to get a gas cylinder from this boss, but it's just too expensive to fight because you need Genesis weapons to kill him. And I kinda would not bother, you know. It's kind of annoying to just fight him. So he resides in a room after this. I'm just gonna kill this frozen boulder here. Kill this toxic spear. And he's in here. There he is. I'm not gonna go in there. He's gonna kill me. We're just gonna enter this room. Kill all these frozen zombies. This bloater as well. Grip our last AK. Kill this frozen bloater right here. The pathetic corpse. Or you can only... Or you can use like a normal gas masks. Gas mask, actually. Two of them. Ooh, think about that. It's all experience. So much damage they deal. It's just unholy. I don't even know. I just find to hold the shoot button so I just don't miss. And they're dead. And I think this is the last room. No. What's her name? Oh, okay. We're punching. Punching this guy. He's healing. Agility. Work. Come on. And he did. Bam. Just punched the frozen bloater. And this should be the end of this place, please. Thank you. So, we have now finished the Sector B1 and all of the, and both of the A sectors. So now we're just gonna return back home. I'm not going to clear the fourth one. I don't need to. So, I'll see you guys when I'm back here with a clear inventory. See you guys in a bit. Hello everybody, and now we're back at the laboratory. So now we do have the 250 keycard A and keycard Bs. If only I had the same as like hard mode keycards, I would open these ones as well. But since now we only have the normal ones, we'll just open these ones. So we're going to begin with the A card. Oh my goodness, that's actually decent. Now we're just gonna take this armor. Gonna put it in our inventory here. Grab most of the items. Why do I feel like you could get more back then? And this is the B1 with SWAT and more Genesis weapons. So you usually would clear this place for the Genesis weapons, because the Genesis weapons are the thing that you need, or like the most worth it here, and they are like the things that you need to clear a hard mode laboratory, which is kind of absolutely like a lot of items that you need to get, because thinking about it, you need to use that much guns to just clear three floors, like a full inventory of guns that I just had, I needed to use to clear most of the laboratory. Now that I think about it, it's actually pretty cheap. But it's still a lot of guns, considering that you needed that much to just fully clear it. So, I guess that'll be the end of this video now. To be honest, guys, with the recent amount of support and love that I've been getting from my past videos, is just completely amazing to me. You guys are absolutely amazing. Thank you so much for tuning into my YouTube channel, commenting and liking. I cannot say thank you enough to you guys, and because of you guys, I'm getting a new appreciation for Last Day on Earth, and I'm actually very happy that I'm slowly building up a community here of very amazing people that are amazing. That's just basically it. And I'm glad that everybody's enjoying the videos. So if you did enjoy this video, please hit the subscribe button, like the video, comment down below. I've been reading most of you guys' comments and hearing you guys compliment and drop ideas and videos they want to see is very heartwarming, and those videos will come soon enough, because I do have some video ideas planned out. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Adios.